fault. There weren't a lot of shots, but a lot of good quality shots by the Bruins.
And one of the big acquisitions in hockey this season is in goal for Pittsburgh.
10-2-3 in his last 15 games. A lot of people say the reason why Pittsburgh is over 500 this season, Tommy Barrasso.
And of course, Mario Lemieux, the league's leading scorer, will be out there in this one. Claude Loisel off the faceoff against John Cullen. And the Devils will get it back early. Randy Valachek will bring it in. Valachek could not control. Taken away by the Penguins. Scott Bjugstad, and now behind the play, sticks are up. Claude Loisel involved in the discussion with John Cullen, the rookie, and that didn't take very long. And they're both going to go to the penalty box here, just 13 seconds into the game.
Now, one of the reasons why Pittsburgh will come out and try and play in a very aggressive game is the fact that the Devils have had such success against the Pittsburgh Penguins. The last 10 games, the Devils are 7-1-2 against the Pittsburgh Penguins. The last four games here in this building, the Devils are 3 wins, no losses, and a tie. So Pittsburgh wants to turn that around.
There's Loisel going in the box.
New Jersey penalty.
See what the penalties are here.
Loisel, 2 minutes for roughing.
Roughing on Loisel.
Number 11, John Cullen.
And Cullen gets two for slashing. So roughing on Loisel, slashing on Cullen at 13 seconds into the game. Pittsburgh leads the National Hockey League in penalties with 38 per game. The Devils the third most. 33.9 penalty minutes per game. So both these clubs are up there in those numbers. Bobby Sauve holding it up in behind the net. Cleared out of the zone. Pittsburgh will have to chase this one down. Jim Johnson back on defense. Johnson working out there with Steve Dykstra on the defensive pairing right now. The scratch list continues to grow for both of these teams, as especially the New Jersey Devils and the injuries they are suffering through.
Well, the main injuries, Sean Burke, Patrick Sundstrom, and John McClain, should be back by the Devils' next regular season game. That's the January 6th home versus Buffalo. So that is the one good thing about those three injured players.
For Pittsburgh, the big loss is Arlie Zalapski. Outstanding season, averaging a point a game, right knee arthroscopic surgery, out 6 to 8 weeks.
He was injured last game against Philadelphia in a collision with Craven. And this is a big loss because the Pittsburgh Penguins have already traded Bodger and Cern, so he was a real good puck-carrying defenseman aside from Coffey.
Kerber's got it out in front, taken away, never got in on goal. Backed out by the Devils, who started up ice just into the first minute here on this New Year's Eve day. Dropped down offside to Korn, and the faceoff will be out at center. Portions of this game brought to you by Budweiser. Beechwood aged for that distinctively clean, crisp taste that makes Budweiser the king of beers. For all you do, this Bud's for you. That, folks, is a shiner.
And now Jim Korn today will be playing on a line with Kurt Muller and Patty Verbeek. The line of Loisel, Brown, and Anderson, the one effective line the last couple games, is staying together. And now Chris Jehocke, called up from Utica just today, will be playing on a line with Broughton and Magic Johnson.
Jehocke, they were sewing the name on the uniform prior to this game. He just came up, literally. Bob Erie dumps it in. Erie chasing it down. 8 goals, 6 assists, last dozen games for him. He is playing well for them. Coffey able to hold it in for the moment. Rolled to center. Jehocke got it. Broughton got hit from behind by Mark Johnson that time. Here's Lemieux, league's leading scorer, Mario Lemieux. And he is on another one of his torrid scoring streaks. 44 games. Last season, this season, Lemieux, shot was blocked. Sauve went out to play it. Rob Brown at an empty net. Tried to center, and Jehocke was there to knock it away. That was close. Jehocke's drop pass to Broughton all alone. In shot saved by Barrasso. Nobody was between he and the goaltender.
And the fact that puck was just a little bit out of Broughton's reach didn't allow him to see that situation right away. He wound up for the slap shot, assuming the defenseman was going to come across, but the defenseman was tied up, couldn't come across, and that let Broughton cut in. He was still a little bit of a tough angle.
There you see, Tom Barrasso has always played well against the Devils, whether with Pittsburgh or with this club, lifetime. He is 9-1-3 against New Jersey, with a 2.96 goals against.
Over the last couple of seasons, I don't think there's any question that Barrasso has been the outstanding goaltender outside of the division. Because it's a different thing when you see a goaltender 6 or 7 times as far as rating them. But he has been the best goaltender outside of the Patrick division that the Devils have faced.
That's when he was with Buffalo, and now, unfortunately for the Devils, he is in the division.
So
doesn't make it any easier. Anders Carlson. Lots of ice time for Anders Carlson. He's been playing well for the Devils. With all their injuries and people not playing well, he's getting it. Brown shot saved by Barrasso. Brown also getting more work now since coming back up from Utica. Held in by Rooney. Valachek at center dumped it in. Devils have to get back onside. Barrasso going back to get it. No score here. First 2.5 minutes of it. They'll wave off the icing. Tove will leave it for Cirella. Full house here again. 14 of the 20 games at home, Pittsburgh has sold out. They've had 8 sellouts in a row. That happens when you're number one in your division and you have Mario Lemieux and Coffey out there on the ice. That one shot back in, almost caught Johnson in the head. Brown hitting it in as Pittsburgh came up along the blue line. Just stood the Devils up. Devils wanted to change up in any event. Back the other way with it, Gord Denine. Denine sending it in, Sauvé. Devils have had trouble last 3 games coming out of the zone. Losing a couple to the Rangers, 1 to the Bruins, and they do not get out cleanly on this one. This will be an icing call at the other end when Denine touches it right there. 17:05 to go, first period from Pittsburgh. No score. This is the National Hockey League on Sports Channel. Dave Hannanin to take the faceoff against Kirk Muller. Here's a man who'd like to find a way to get to the net.
One of the things that Kirk Muller has to do is just play with that abandon. He can't worry about the statistics. He has to go each game now and worry about that as it comes.
Point shot was deflected. Rod Buskus getting the shot off. It did not go through. Claude Loisel sends it in. Devils in 3 meetings have beaten Pittsburgh 6-4 and tied them twice, 4-4 and 2-2. Coffey just wide. Coffey ripping that one from the red line. Hard shot put on behind the play. Devils may get the advantage here. Pittsburgh getting back on defense in the middle for Beek. Coffey was there to block it. Good play by Coffey. Muller charging in trying to hold it. And the Devils brought it in. It had gone outside the line. That will draw an offside whistle.
Good stiff check thrown there by Kirk Muller and Paul Coffey. Coffey just seen at the last minute. But again, the one thing that Kirk Muller does not do is stop playing a physical game. Now, the statistics there are disappointing. I've talked to Kirk several times about it. He knows that he is having statistically not a good season. But the one thing he doesn't stop doing is work hard. It's amazing. A lot of players will, you can see their whole disposition on and off the ice will, you can't talk to them, you want to stay away from them. Kirk's always there to say hello. He is captain of this team, and he works very hard at keeping this team together because this is a difficult time. The Devils went this month, started this month 2 points out of a playoff spot behind Philadelphia. They've been 500 for the month, and they're 9 points out of a playoff spot. So
that's how well those Patrick Division teams are playing.
Look at Caulfield. Now, Caulfield's 6'4", 240 pounds. Muller takes the check, keeps his eye on the puck, and just great balance, and he comes up the ice. And the one thing about Kirk is he has tremendous balance on his skates.
Psychologically today, you really sensed in the Devils' locker room before the game, they understand that even though they're only midway in the season, this is a crunch time for them. They cannot afford to get any further behind for the number 4 team, and that's 9 points right now. And on the other side, as Peter mentioned, to Pittsburgh, in down low, backhand, they score! They got it! Kirk Muller would set that one up on a beautiful backhand pass, and Jimmy Korn, black eye and all, has got himself a goal, 1-0 New Jersey.
Over the last 3 games, the Devils have been outscored 8-1 in the first period. They wanted to come out and have a strong period, and they got a break on this goal. Good play by Muller, but Korn gets the puck. He cuts in front. This actually will bounce off Hanna's foot and into the net. Watch a nice play by Muller right there, but Korn will lose it right there. It hits right off the toe of Hanna, goes behind Barrasso. But a good break for the Devils. It gets in that early lead, something they haven't been getting since Christmas.
8th goal of the season for Jim Korn, and they haven't had many breaks like that over the last month of December either. Most of those bounces have gone the other way. Muller getting the goal. Korn the goal. Muller and Kerber's getting the assists on it. And the Devils have a 1-0 lead. Goal coming at 3:39. Mentioning psychologically for Pittsburgh, as Peter was talking about, it's what do we do to beat the New Jersey Devils. For some reason, they just seem to have our number, and starting out like that won't make Pittsburgh feel any better.
Exactly. They need a big game from Lemieux, because once a team...
Lemieux centering. Score! Mario Lemieux's centering pass! Hit for tap! That went off a Devil's skate and went in. Lemieux will get the goal, and it's 1-1.
or is this the Mutiny's any help from the Devils players as far as a lucky bounce? But we're just talking about they need a big game from Lemieux. And here he makes that good, strong move to the outside. He's going to pass the puck in front of the net. It actually hits off Craig Willanen's foot and bounces right back in past Bobby Sauvé. A tough break for the Devils. Now, the Devils have to really regroup here right now. They can't let Pittsburgh build on this because they had them down after that goal thinking, my God, this is it. We're never going to beat this club.
Right out in front, Lemieux centered it right through the crease. Willanen let it go. Bob Erie able to hold it in. Lemieux getting his 39th of the season. Puck loose in the slot. Devils kick it away. Willanen back. They just trying to take the heat off now as they dump out the center. Right back in, Erie. Erie got Lemieux. Lemieux, dangerous shot. That deflected off Mark Johnson's skate. Rotten clearing it up and out. Lemieux's 39th. Robbie Brown gets the assist at 4:17. Brown was questionable for today. He took a Lemieux shot off his right heel in the last game against Philadelphia. He'll be one of our guests during our intermission coming up today. First intermission, but Brown's all right to play, even though that heel's hurting him. Mark Johnson cleared it out through the middle. Lemieux, the National Hockey League's leading scorer, and Rob Brown right now is fifth in the National Hockey League with 63 points. Johnson all tied at 1-1. Johnson's drop pass knocked away and cleared out of the zone. Back to get it is Coffey. Rooney was able to back that out for the Devils. Sauvé will play it. Bobby Sauvé in his last three games has not had a lot of luck with him either. Devils have not played well in front of him, and those kind of goals have been going in against him.
The last game against Boston, the score was 2-1 late in the third period. There was a turnover deep in the Devils' zone. They'd only had three shots against them the whole period. Bounces in off one of the Devils' defensemen, gives Boston a 3-1 lead. Turned the whole complexion of the game around.
Pass off the boards, went to Dan Quinn. Quinn with a man in front, tried to get it to Cunnyworth. Knocked away by Joe Cirella. Cirella will bring it up, Perry Anderson with him. And an offside call. We've got 13:50 remaining in the first. Goals by Korn and Lemieux have made it 1-1. This is the National Hockey League on Sports Channel. Pittsburgh had an 8-game win streak before that loss to Philadelphia, a 3-2 loss in their last game. This has been a red-hot hockey team and riding atop that Patrick division right now. 1-1 the score here. Cleared out of the zone, Tommy Abelin for the Devils. Abelin teaming up with Tom Kerbers. Goes to the middle to Muller. Muller ridden off the puck and a penalty coming up. And it's going to be a holding call, and it's going to be against Pittsburgh, and the Devils will get the first power play chance of the game.
Kirk Muller went down right there. It looked like he may have injured his left arm. Let's see what happened here. He lands on it right there. And when he got up, he had it tucked close in against his body. Watch when he gets back to the bench as the trainer doesn't have a look at him.
He was in some degree of pain. There you see Phil Bourque going out for the hold at 6:29. Devils will go on the power play here. New Jersey, 19th in the league with a power play that has been just 16.6% effective. Devils have scored only 38 power play goals in 229 chances. And they're up against a Pittsburgh penalty-killing team. Not had all that much luck either. They're 17th in the league, having given up 53 power play goals. Korn, he gets hauled down by Johnson. Korn kept the puck in, though. Callahan falling down, got it away to Verbeek. No glove pass called on it. And that one's going to be tipped up and into the stands. Mike O'Callaghan got the stick on it as it was batted up in the air by Troy Loney.
Gary, it's interesting walking around Pittsburgh, looking at the difference in the fans' reaction to the Pittsburgh Penguins now and, say, 4 or 5 years ago. Last, when you walked around 4 or 5 years ago, all you saw were Pittsburgh Steeler hats, sweatshirts, whatever. Now, cab drivers, people in just walking around the streets, they've got 66 on, they've got Pittsburgh Penguin hats. They really have captured the imagination of the Pittsburgh people.
There's nothing like winning, is there?
Well, the Devils, it's the same thing with the Devils.
Sure.
Just started last summer, and it's built the same sort of popularity in the New Jersey area.
They had never sold so much of the concession stands for the Devils as they did last season. Last Christmas was a bonanza. The Devils off to that fantastic start they had. cleared down on Sove. We've got a 1-1 game here. Minute 30 on the New Jersey Devils power play. As the Devils try and get the lead back again, Mark Johnson sends it in. Barrasso could not stop it. Johnson is able to again flip it out. Jimmy Johnson clearing the zone twice. O'Callaghan being challenged at the other end, able to avoid Dave Hannon. Minute 11 on the power play. Muller. Muller just trying to get grouped up here. Muller's got room in the middle. Tried to get it down low to Korn, but had it taken away. He had Korn open. Lemieux was there. Mario Lemieux, 6 shorthanded goals this season. He'll rag back behind the defense, given the opportunity, even when they're shorthanded. There he was up in the forecheck on Johnson. Hope checked away. Lemieux's out in front of the right. Broughton trying to cut the angle off. Lemieux and Broughton. Lemieux in. Score! That's a Mario Lemieux goal. His 7th shorthanded goal of the year. And Pittsburgh leads it 2-1.
The Devils were changing, trying to get a fresh set of legs out there. Aaron Broughton is the last man back. Now Lemieux looks up. The player of Lemieux's ability will instinctively know that this is a forward. He knows that number 10 is Aaron Broughton, normally a forward. So he gets the puck right here. It looks like he's going to go wide. He sees Broughton. He knows he's going to try and put a move on him. Takes it inside and outside. But it actually catches a break and hits his foot and bounces in. So Lemieux has scored 2 goals, 1 kicked in by Lennon and 1 he kicked in. I was looking to see if any of the Devil players were going to question whether Lemieux had purposely put that in, but they didn't.
7:50 shorthanded goal, number 40 for Lemieux. Now Broughton and Erie have the sticks up. Lemieux getting the assist from Hillier, who broke it out of the zone. And Lemieux's having a start like he usually doesn't have against New Jersey. A real good one. We'll be back. 11:55 left in the first. Pittsburgh leading it 2-1. This is the NHL on Sports Channel.
Aaron Broughton. He's a forward going up against Mario Lemieux. It's so difficult. Well, you saw Broughton. He looked down at the puck. When you see Mario Lemieux, he tantalizes you with that puck. It's out here. It's over there. But the fact is that it's so... forwards just don't practice it enough to stop a normal good rush of a forward. But when you have a Mario Lemieux, you know Aaron Broughton knew he was in big trouble.
And even if he gets in front of him, Broughton's so small compared to Lemieux, he'd run right over him probably in any event. Sove came out and tried to cut the angle down on it. Harry Anderson pinned up by Johnson, away to Brown. Brown, Loisel out in front. 2-1 score. Still the power play. 6 seconds left on it for the Devils. Brown in. Shot. Save. Rebound is loose. Sitting there. It came out. It came out. Barrasso was able to kick it away. Here's Lemieux again. Over to Dave Hannon. Back to Lemieux. Didn't get all of it. Hannon. Penalty is over. You're back to even strength. They'll dump it to center to regroup. Those penalties on Broughton and Erie at 8:05 are matching minors, so no advantage on those. Wide to Brown. That's going to be a two-liner. And brings the faceoff inside the Pittsburgh end.
One thing the Devils did so far this season, in the 3 games they have played Pittsburgh, they've won the first game 6-4 at the Meadowlands. They tied 4-4 in a very exciting game here on December 10th. Lemieux getting 2 goals in the last 10 minutes to tie that up. The Devils did an exceptional job of keeping Lemieux off the scoreboard for the first 50 minutes of that game. And then, Gary, probably the best game of the season, I felt. The 2-2 tie, Pittsburgh and the Devils, the 23rd of December. Barrasso and Burke, 1-2 as far as stars are concerned. Just a great game. I think we can look for that tonight, although so far this game, it's been a lot of funny breaks going against the goaltenders.
Yeah, we've seen the puck bouncing all over the place. That is the 6 shorthanded goal Devils have given up. In front shot, never got in on goal. That one was blocked. Going down in front, Scott Bukestad. Good play by Bukestad, the former North Star. Blocked the centering pass. Coffey stood up at center by Craig Wallanen. That one's knocked away. Danico tipping it. Rod Buskus going over to get it. Penguins now have 11 shorthanded goals. 7 of them for Lemieux. This one's rolling in on Sove, and he had to play that. Sove had Dan Quinn breaking in on him. Johnson ties up the other way. Penalty coming up on him. Delayed call. Muller again involved. Kirk Muller playing an aggressive game. Has drawn a couple of penalties. By Pittsburgh Penguins.
Muller breaking through the middle, yelling. You can hear him from up here, all the way up here, that he was screaming for that puck as he knew he had a step. Johnson, the left side defenseman, has to come across. Muller always does a good job of protecting the puck. He didn't have it out in front of him. Now, Verbeek, excellent pass right here. But watch how Muller protects the puck. If he has it in front of him, Johnson's able to reach for the stick and the puck. If Muller kept it off to the side, Johnson has to pull him down. Good pass by Verbeek. Nice play by Muller.
That strength of Kirk Muller, strong enough so that Johnson couldn't just shove him off the puck. He had to hold that stick in the midsection for a long time, and that's what will draw the penalty. So the Devils will go back on their second power play opportunity here. As the ice being fixed up in front of Barrasso.
If the Devils were to come into any one building needing a victory, as far as the players are concerned, this would be the building. They have great confidence against Pittsburgh anywhere, but they have great confidence against them in this building. They came in today. They knew how important the game was. I heard three or four of them say, there's one place you want to be, it's here for today's game.
It's been a good place for the New Jersey Devils and a good team for them to play against. Devils have a career record of 24-15-5 against this Pittsburgh club. And the
score! It went in! It went in off Dave Hannon, I believe, after it was poked out in front by Kurt Muller.
Jimmy Korn again getting the puck, taking down two players, gets a puck out to Verbeek. Verbeek makes a nice little pass. Now, I think Verbeek initially is surprised how open Kirk Muller is. But when the puck gets to Muller, Muller takes the puck, makes a quick move. They see Korn down, take two players. Verbeek gets the puck to Muller right here. Muller brings it up front, throws it down under Barrasso's glove. So Kirk Muller again off to that big start in today's game. He always matches up against Mario Lemieux. He loves that confrontation. Playing against Mario, he plays so well against the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Puck's just exploding into the net. These goals are coming on very quick plays. That'll be the 12th goal of the season for Kirk Muller's 26th point. Power play goal at 9:46 has tied this game up at 2-2.
It's important for the Devils to get back and tie this hockey game because
that one just tipped wide.
The shots right now, when that goal was scored, were 7-2 for the Devils. Both of the Pittsburgh shots going in the net.
Tom Barrasso playing it. Muller's goal at 9:46 on the power play from Verbeek and Korn, tying the game up at 2-2. So Jim Korn's got a goal and an assist. Here's Hannon. Hannon shot, saved by Solvay. Dave Hannon got out in front. And nobody better look down for more than a couple of seconds on this one on the ice because the puck is moving quickly when somebody gets the offense flowing. Good check by Bourque. Freed up Lemieux. Lemieux dropped it in the middle. Backhand shot. Didn't get it off. Penalty coming up on the Devils as Jay Caulfield got hauled down. Hooking call on Muller. 9:22 to go. First period power play coming up. We pause for a regional break. The NHL on Sports Channel.
New Jersey penalty.
You see Lemieux making that move to the forehand. So many players make the good move to the backhand, but Lemieux actually with the best move he has is to the forehand. And it's his move to the backhand is very good, but very few players move both ways as well as Lemieux does. Usually it's one or the other. For example, Coffey always goes and makes the move to his right, but he uses his speed. But Lemieux can go either way, and that's what makes him so difficult.
Currently a 14-game, now 15-game scoring streak for him. Well, in the last 15 games, he has now picked up 17 goals and 21 assists for Mario Lemieux. Now we are getting a bench minor. Too many men on the ice. Now, Kirk Muller had already gone into the box. Muller had gone off for a hooking at 10:38, and now Verbeek is going to serve a bench minor, and the Devils are going to be short two. How do you make a mistake like that in that situation?
The Devils were making a line change, and the linesman was standing right there. Again, it's a five-foot rule that's now in effect in the National Hockey League. And they watch it very closely. Every once in a while, the newsletter will come out to remind them on what penalties to call. It seems in the last few days they've really been watching for that one.
All right, big power play chance, 5-on-3. Lemieux, Coffey, Lemieux, shot. So they got a piece of that one with a pad. 5-on-3 power play for the Pittsburgh Penguins here. They've got the full 2 minutes.
Score! Mario Lemieux, the perfect trick! Lemieux has is a perfect hat trick, three in the first period, and we're only halfway through his fourth hat trick of the year. 3-2 Pittsburgh.
Well, pretty play between Coffey and Lemieux. This is his second chance of firing the puck. You'll see Bobby Sobe just slightly screened. The puck hits just off his stick and bounces in behind him. Mario Lemieux, who's had an injured wrist and it cut down on his shooting, but now that wrist appears to be better. He's been shooting the puck a lot more the last few games.
Nothing wrong with that wrist. Perfect hat trick for him. Power play goal, 5-on-3, 3-2 Pittsburgh, and now the power play will continue. They still have a minute 39 remaining on the second penalty. Coffey getting one of the assists, and Dineen picking up the other. Now 3-2. And a very dangerous part of the first period as both these teams really pushing the rubber into the twine here. Lemieux, 5-on-4 power play. Randy Valachek able to clear it out. Coffey's back. Barrasso will play it. Usually against the Devils, Mario Lemieux doesn't get wound up until the third period. Devils have been able to shut him off fairly well. Not today. And the Devils, who are continuing to give up lots of goals, having trouble in this one early on. Brown, quick leading scorer. Got it down deep. Joe Sorella poked away. Here's Lemieux. 52 on the power play. Lemieux looking in front. Turnaround. Brown. Shot saved. Sobe. Rebound. Lemieux back to the point. Shot there. Deflected up and into the air. Gord Dineen got the shot off. Devils break it out. 36 on the Devils penalty. Devils shorthanded effort. Sorella holding. Got it in front. Still there. Rolled in on Barrasso. Just no. It did not go in. It went between his legs, hit the post, and came out.
Yeah, we would have seen a great argument right there because the referee had actually blown the whistle before Sorella took that shot. Had that puck gone in, the goal wouldn't have counted. And you know that the Devils would have been all over the referee in that one. But you see, the puck is actually free. Barrasso never has it. And it just hits the post, but the referee had already blown the whistle.
Barrasso hit it with his skate after as well. Yeah, if that had gone in, we'd really had him up in the air. Jim Schoenfeld's club trailing here 3-2, 7:48 remaining as we've got a shootout in the first period. Pittsburgh coming into this game, loaded with offense, of course. They've scored 171 goals this season. Devils just 129. Still a power play here for the Penguins. 15 seconds left on it. John Cullen got it in on Sobe, tipped away. Back over to Lemieux. Lemieux's going for four in a period. 3 seconds on it. In front, just tipped. Purvis was there to knock it away. Penalty is over. Johnson holds it down deep. Pennyworth. Cullen having trouble with it, but he's still got it. Back here at even strength now. Power play is over. Lemieux out in front of the net being tied up. Pennyworth knocked down. Devils get it. Devils have a 3-on-2 chance the other way. Brought back to Verbeek. In the middle, Mark Johnson. Verbeek dropped it to him. Johnson shot. Save Barrasso. 3-on-2 chance. Good play by Barrasso on the straight-on shot. Mike Johnson again. Jammed up by Cunningworth. Johnson's pass around to Lemieux. Lemieux tipped it back, got it back. Cunningworth. Lemieux finally is going to go to the bench. He stayed out for about 4 minutes. Verbeek starting it up. Lemieux with a perfect hat trick. All three coming here in the first period. Who knows where this one will end up if he starts out a day like that. Wallana knocked down, dumped it in around the net to Danico, up to Muller, played by Verbeek. Verbeek, Muller, and Korn on this line. Wallana with it and just swept it in, intercepted, brought out by Randy Hillier. Pass back for Hillier from Troy Loney. Sobe knocked it away. Korn tying it up with Bukestad, centered right out in front. Devils there. Wallana. Chris Chahaki just up today from Utica. Welcome to the boards. Compliments of Mr. Coffey. And that's not Joe DiMaggio. Back out along the blue line. Intercepted. Sorry about that. Troy Loney got it off to Hannon. Hannon brings it in. Sorella.
the end of the year. You get one a year. Puck still free. Devils will come out. 5:30 left to go here in the first period. 3-2. Pittsburgh leading it. Lemieux had them all for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Right now we're just going up and down the ice. Gord Denis sends that one in. Caulfield. Good shot by Caulfield. Centering pass was away, though. Caulfield and Sorella entangled behind the action. Brown had a poke check. Devils were offside. 5:06 to go. First period from the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh, where the Penguins have a 1-1 goal lead. 16 NHL career hat tricks, four of them this season. He's the leading assist man all time for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Goals scored, he's third behind Pronovo and Keogh. And in points, Mario Lemieux trails only Rick Keogh in Pittsburgh's franchise history, and not by much, only about 33 right now. And before long, he'll hold every offensive category leadership for this club.
And in the National Hockey League,
yeah,
he's going. I mean, chasing Gretzky would be the only goal by the time his career is over. But the thing that Devils have always had is almost a psychological handle on Mario Lemieux for themselves and for the Pittsburgh Penguins. They felt that Mario didn't have his best games against the Devils. So the Devils want to stop it right now, make this, at this one period, the only time he's able to do this. The Devils to work right now at reestablishing that control over Mario.
And they're down by only one here, 3-2. Long way to go at 4:30 left to go here in the first period of Pittsburgh for this packed house. Brown drops it back in the middle of Loisel. Over the head of Barrasso. Rebound came deep to Brown. His shot was blocked by Bort. Curvers the shot. That's deflected up. 90 rows back. And went all the way to the back of the reserve seats in the first tier. .419 remaining here in the second. Pittsburgh leading at 3-2. This is the National Hockey League on Sports Channel. Pushed in on goal, Barrasso whips it off the sideboards. Pittsburgh has scored three goals on seven shots in this game. The Devils, 2-for-9. Not a lot of shots, but a lot of scoring. O'Callaghan. Anders Carlson sends it in. Coffey's there to play it. O'Callaghan holding it down to Muller. Muller, carry on his back, takes him down. Horn. Carlson. Horn kicking at it, held onto by Coffey. Got it down to Muller. Barry moves in. Horn moves in, and the puck comes free. Coffey gets it up to Lemieux, can't get it out. Anders Carlson saved Barrasso. Lemieux looking to break Rob Brown. Brown with a head up, had it taken away by Danico. Devils will change. Coffey's pass still in that zone. Barry's got it. Back checking by Verbeek. Freed that one up. Broughton offside. About the third time here in the first period, Devils have had offside trying to go in.
Aaron Broughton. Aaron Broughton's brother. Speaking of Aaron Broughton and his brother in shorthanded goals, which we aren't, but the situation has been the last six goals that Aaron Broughton's brother has scored. Five of them were shorthanded. Sort of unusual statistic. I was talking to him about it today, and he said that he talked to Neil, and Neil says there's no reason for it. It's just one of those lucky streaks we go on where other teams are changing and getting those quick breaks. But it shows you just how important those shorthanded goals are. In those games that he has played, Minnesota has won them all.
Well, the Rangers with that 2-1 lead, that's the only other afternoon game. We will update you later on during one of our intermissions on the standings. We've got a penalty coming up right here, though, a hooking call. That one coming down as Patty Verbeek got dumped on the ice, and it'll be another power play chance coming up here for the Devils. The other game, the Red Army playing against Boston, they're in the second.
And it would be a gala international event, fans, when the Devils take on the Soviet Union Central Red Army team Monday afternoon, January 2nd at 1:35, with tickets now on sale at all Ticketmaster outlets and the Meadowlands Arena box office. Ticket prices are $24, $20, $19, and $12. That's Monday afternoon, January 2nd, the Devils and the best of the Soviet Union, the Central Red Army. Please call 201-935-6050.
We will have that game for you right here on Sports Channel. as the Devils take on Central Red Army team. Power play, Quinn is out. Dan Quinn for hooking at 17 minutes. Shot by Broughton, hit the side of the net. Broughton trying to hold it in. The Devils with a chance to get this tied up. The third power play of the game. Held in by O'Callaghan to Broughton. New has one shorthanded goal here in this first period. O'Callaghan, Broughton. 3-2 Pittsburgh lead. O'Callaghan on the fly. Penalty in front of the net. And there they go. Down on the ice after taking the cross check is Jim Johnson. Steve Rooney's the one who got him. And then Rooney got into it with Troy Loney, who came in to retaliate on Johnson's behalf.
Now, Steve Rooney has been put out there to stand in front of the net. Jim Johnson, who played an exceptionally aggressive game December 23rd against the Devils at the Meadowlands, was playing Rooney, playing Rooney. Then he turned his back, and when he did, Steve Rooney paid him back with a cross check. Johnson goes down. Rooney goes to the penalty box. But when Johnson was doing that, you have to remember that a guy like Steve Rooney is not going to take that. This is his first game back. He's out for 10 games. And he is going to be, looks like they're talking about throwing him out for the game.
Maybe.
I think they've given him a five-minute cross-checking penalty.
Rooney and Loney have both gone to the box. And there goes Steve Rooney heading to the dressing room. We have just 2:29 left here, so we obviously have drawn at least 4 minutes.
You know, Gary, the thing that always bothers me about this, defenseman goes down. And you never want to see anybody injured. No question about that. That's his wife right there watching him go off. She's very happy. That's Jim Johnson's wife watching him go off. But if that happens to a forward and he's knocked down, referees will let that go. I'm telling you, it happens more times than not. The fellow will go down in front and then he'll go to the referee and say, what? You know, the guy's lying on the ice. That's what the price you pay for going in there. So there is a real contradiction in how they call these penalties. And I can't believe that Steve Rooney, if that had been Rooney that got down and you, Johnson had done it, I guarantee you he only would have gotten 2 minutes.
Wow. Game misconduct, five for cross-checking and two for roughing. 5 minutes.
I think the two for roughing came with Troy Loney.
Troy Loney gets the two for roughing.
They both got two for roughing, and Rooney gets five, and the game misconduct.
No, he's got both. Rooney is going to get a roughing, a cross-checking, and a game misconduct.
Yeah, but Loney got two for...
Yeah, so offset those.
Offset those. So it's not a seven-minute penalty.
No.
It's just the five.
Just five. All right. Devils, who are down 3-2 with just 2:29 left here in the first period, in trouble right here as Muller's getting the information back to Jim Schoenfeld on the bench as to what the calls were. Dan Maruelli, the referee here, had the Devils in the last game when there were lots of incidents going on against the Boston Bruins. And now the Devils will have to contend again with Pittsburgh coming up with a power play here in a minute 29. Pittsburgh already has that penalty being served by Quinn when these extra ones came at 17:31. Quinn's penalty had been at 17:30. And it's Hannon on Tommy Avalon, taken away by Patty Verbeek. Over to Muller. 4-on-4 for the moment. Avalon. Middle, Verbeek couldn't get it. Kick not out. Verbeek held it in. Couldn't get handle on the puck, though, and he was cleared out by Gord Dineen. Tommy Kerber's back to get it. Minute 56 left to go here in the period. Pittsburgh will get their power play started here. Gord Dineen lost it in front. Muller the shot. Deflected out in front by Dineen. Back over to Kerber's. Kerber's. Avalon. Tommy Avalon, the defenseman, down low on Dineen. Devils holding it in here in this 4-on-4 situation. Kerber's back to Muller. Had Pittsburgh running a bit. Back in the middle of turnaround, Tommy Avalon. That one blocked. And finally, it'll be taken by Hannon. Randy Hillier blocked that shot. The big trying to get it away couldn't. Hillier starts it up. 20 seconds to the power play for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Joe Sorella will chase this down. 13 to Pittsburgh's power play. Lemieux's out on the ice to go at it again. Coffey got the power play there. Call it over to Lemieux. Pittsburgh gets it into the zone. You waiting for that penalty to expire. Get it right out in front. Ed Cullen breaking. 1 minute to go in the period. Power play underway. Be a 3 minute, 30 second power play. Shorthanded Johnson. Save made by Barrasso. 50 seconds left in the period. Pittsburgh skating 5-on-4 right here for the extended power play. Pittsburgh has picked up one power play goal. Well, this is their third chance of the game. Lemieux gets it in. Sauvé had it on the back of the net. Cirella gloved it off and couldn't control it. Lemieux. Cullen took that puck after Cirella had picked it up off the back of the net. Lemieux going for four. Cullen. Cullen in. Had that one tipped away. 22 seconds in the period.
Good play by Joe Cirella. Cullen coming out of the corner. He just came down, read the pass, and tipped the puck off. Cullen stopped him from cutting in front of the net.
12 seconds in the period. Broughton, Cunnyworth. Seconds running off here. Devils doing a good job killing the time, even though it's still in the zone. And now they get it out, and that will do it for the period. So the Pittsburgh Penguins will be back with 2 minutes and 31 seconds remaining on their power play, and will take to the dressing room that one-goal lead.
Gary, very interesting period. That was not a poorly played period by the goaltenders on either club. A couple of them were kicked in by their own teammates. Mario Lemieux got a goal. Kirk Muller had a good goal. But the fact was, it was just a strange period of hockey. I mean, the Devils have to look at is the fact that even though Lemieux got those goals, they're only down by one. Muller had a strong period, really played well, so that they had to go in and come back now, kill this penalty off, and come back and attack them the same way they started this game.
Mario Lemieux leaving with a hat trick, all three coming here in the first, as Pittsburgh has a 3-2 lead. And during our first intermission, we will be joined by Rob Brown of the Pittsburgh Penguins, and we will bring you up to date on the standings and the schedule for the National Hockey League on this day before the new year. We'll be back to Pittsburgh. You're watching the National Hockey League on Sports Channel.